Hey guys, Joel from Crazy Restorations. We're having a look at the 1973 BMW 2002. This car we had blown it completely apart and rotisserie mounted it for medium blasting. We just picked it back up from the blasters today and we're going to be putting it in a epoxy coating. We just want to go over what we found on the body once we got it back from the medium blasters. The whole front clip of the car, we've got some serious issues here, if you can see from the video, but everything is just rusted out. This is Swiss cheese on the fender. The inner structure here, as you can see, everything's gone in this corner. So that's pretty much the whole front clip. Let's have a look at the bottom side here and then we'll move over. You can see where this has all been patched in. Again, there's still rust there. The rust wasn't removed, so I don't know how that was handled when it was done, but we're gonna have to fix it and get rid of the rust and the ugliness. Okay, let's step over to the driver's side here. We've got the same issue on this corner. Pretty much this whole area is just gone. On the back side, same thing. You can see the rust we're gonna be dealing with there. If we have a look at the inside, bottom of the rad support, you can see this whole area has been sectioned in. The metal that's been put in there is not straight. The welds are very questionable. You know, if this car was to get into a front end collision, I would call this unsafe. Okay, I just want to have a look at the inside here. You can see we've got rust on the firewall and the splash shields, the inner fenders. Looking at the back of the rad support here, again, you can see there's still rust there. That is the patch that's been put in. And again, it looks like it's been put in right over rust. So, very, very bad, we'll call it, attempt to metal repair on the front clip of this car, so we're going to have to address that for the customer and correct all these issues. Looking at the interior floor of the car, not too bad. We do have some rust up here in the front floorboard and firewall, as well as some rust holes right above the pedal area right here. But overall, the floors are a bit cleaner than we were expecting, so that's a good thing. Okay, just come to the back here. Have a look at the left side quarter panel and rocker. Not too bad. There is a little bit of rust on the rocker in the back here, as well as the front. So we'll start at the back and work our way forward. You see the rust around the molding holes, some pinning going on. And then, of course, when we get to the front, there's some, again, ugly patchwork that's been done here and moves us into the fender. Again, you can see there's patchwork done on the bottom here and we still have rust holes and pinholes from the welding. There's rust holes here as well as the bottom. And again, same thing up toward the top. There's some ugly patchwork that has not been repaired properly. Okay, we'll just look at the door and then we'll carry on with the rest of the car. This is the driver's side door. We do have some pinholes on the door skin. So we'll be addressing all of that. There's been some repair work done, possibly a speaker installed at one point in the car's life, and somebody attempted to repair that hole. The hood. Factory hood looks to be in pretty good shape. That's a good thing for us and the customer. Very clean considering the condition of the rest of the vehicle. It's a nice piece, it should look really nice coated. Okay, have a look at the back of the car here. This tail panel, of course, was replaced, and you can see the work that's been done. We've got pinholes all along the seams. There's
holes from grinding, excessive grinding, all down the seam on both sides. I'm not sure if there's any rust holes there, but or if it's just welding and pinholes, but this is an issue. This whole tail panel is a problem. And we'll show you the other side when we get over there. Just having a look at the interior of the floor here. Of course, there's been patchwork over top of rust. So it's kind of pointless to come in and do these little patches like this when you could just replace this entire floor, have one nice solid piece, and you know that's how you restore a car. You don't come in and patch them in like this and hope for the best or what have you. You can see there's some metal damage from a previous accident in the back as well. So it's a no-brainer to just put a new trunk floor in this car. Okay, so let's have a look at the passenger side. Start with the passenger side door here. We do have some more rust on this door than the other door. The outer skin as well as the inner framework. Again, speaker hole been repaired on the inside. Trunk lid. You can see from the top side here, we do have some damage along the edge. And if you want to walk around and have a look on the inside here, basically there's some damage right here as well as rust holes along the edge all the way across. So again, this is going to have to be repaired as well as this lip's going to have to be opened up and all the rust is going to have to be dealt with there, because for all the rust you see, there's probably three times that on the back side that you don't see. Okay, and just having a look at the back of the car. This is the passenger side tail panel seam. We've got the same issue all the way down. You can see from the media blaster that everything was covered with Bondo to sculpt the car. So again, this whole rear tail panel is an issue. Passenger side quarter panel, you can see the, I don't know what to call this, amateur metal repair that's been done. Why would you put something like this on a car? Anyway, this whole quarter panel is an issue, and we'll just show you what we've got. This has been replaced at one point. You can see the brazed marks all along the seam of the quarter panel. This is not the original quarter panel the car came with, so again, rust along the wheel well all the way around. And looking at the rocker, we've got rust pinholes on the rocker here as well. So this quarter panel, possibly when it was installed, could have been a used quarter panel off of a car, or maybe it was installed over top of rust. What was underneath the quarter panel may not have been prepped properly. So again, we've got rust issues that just eventually worked their way back through the quarter panel. Okay, coming forward, we've looked at the interior floors on the driver's side. So on the passenger side, you know, we got a nice size rust hole right here in the corner, as well as this corner over here. So a little bit along the frame rail right here. I don't know if you can see the light through there, but not too bad considering. Looking at the outside, the passenger side fender, again, we've got another patch here. I'm sure there's rust issues there that were not properly taken care of. So this is what we're looking at getting into. Okay, the inner splash shield on the side, the inner fender and the firewall don't look too bad. So not seeing any issues there. So that's a good sign. So pretty much what everything we've pointed out on the video we're going to be getting into. Make the customer aware of this, the issues that are on the car. This was previously supposedly restored by, we'll call it a restoration shop in the western states, but
Again, it's a good thing we went back down to bare metal with this car, because you could see what we found. And everything we found does need to be properly taken care of. So, okay, let's turn the camera off and get this thing in epoxy coat. And we'll keep everybody up to date with videos and pictures as the restoration moves along.